Professional sellers can add products to their Amazon inventory in bulk by uploading a spreadsheet or inventory file. Creating an inventory file takes time, but it can also save time later when you want to add or edit a large number of product listings. Alternatively, Amazon can also generate a template based on the product type that you select. Every product type has attributes that are specific and related to the product type, so it's important to choose the right one when listing. Use them to match your offers to existing listings or to create product detail pages and listings for new products. Remember that you must be a product's brand owner or a brand qualified seller to create a new detail page for an Amazon Brand Registry enrolled product. There are three basic steps in the bulk listing process. 1. Download a spreadsheet template. 2. Add your product information. And 3. Upload your file to Seller Central. Once you've uploaded an inventory file, you can monitor its status and correct any errors that are identified. Let's start with creating your inventory file. You can access this option from the Seller Central main menu. Hover over Catalog, then click Add Products. On the List Your Products page, click Spreadsheet. Under the Spreadsheet tab, click Download Blank Template and choose the template you need from the pop-up menu. Let's start with matching to products already sold in the Amazon store. Select Get Listing Loader in the List Products Already in Amazon's Catalog box. A pop-up box will appear. Select the spreadsheet language and add either the products ASIN, UPC, EAN, or GTIN into the box. You can search up to 500 product IDs to generate a pre-filled spreadsheet. Once you've added all the product IDs, select Generate Spreadsheet. To check the status of your file, click on View Previously Generated Templates. Once your file is ready, you'll see a download button. Click on this button to access your spreadsheet. Start by saving the file as a text tab delimited file or .txt. Using this file format will help reduce the chances of your file having errors and being rejected. Consider adding a date to the file name to keep a record of your work on your local computer. When you open your inventory file template, you'll see multiple tabs. You'll add product information to the template tab. The instructions tab provides guidance on filling in the template. The data definitions tab explains the meaning of each attribute. And the valid values tab provides guidance on the accepted values for each attribute. It's important that you review all the tabs and read through them carefully before you start making changes on the template tab. Select the template tab and fill out all the information for your offer. Anything that has a gray box doesn't need to be filled out. We recommend filling out as many details as possible, but only those with a red box are required. Once you've entered all the information, save your file on your local computer. Later in this training, we walk you through the steps to upload your spreadsheet. Now, let's review how to create new product listings in bulk. Select Download Product Spreadsheet in the List Products that are not currently in Amazon's catalog box. First, you'll search and select the product types you want to list. You can use the search tool, which allows you to identify and select product categories, also called product types. The selections you make add relevant product attribute columns to your inventory file template. For example, if you select the product category digital cameras, columns for video capture, resolution, and audio encoding language will appear. If you want to search for product categories, enter your product name or a descriptor in the search bar and press the search button. For example, you might search for shoes, basketball, or kids' toys. The search tool will list all related product types. Browse carefully and click the Select button next to the product type that matches your product. Each selection you make will appear to the right of the search results. You can click the X next to a selection to remove a category. You can also select Browse via product category to manually browse the different product categories. Locate the overarching category for a product from the list, then select each subcategory to narrow the results. For example, you might select clothing, shoes, and jewelry, then men, watches, and watch bands. Click the Select button next to the subcategory that matches your product, which will add it to the list below for your file template. You might see a Lock and Request Approval button next to some product types. That means you need to obtain approval from Amazon before listing products in that category. Click the Request Approval button, which will take you to our Categories and Products Requiring Approval Help page for step-by-step instructions. After selecting the product categories you want added to your spreadsheet, you'll select the stores where you want to create offers. When you're done, click Generate Spreadsheet to download your inventory file template. Once you've created your template, you'll add your product information. Start by saving the template as a text tab delimited file or .txt. Be sure to add a date to the file name to keep a record of your work. You'll want to use the most recently downloaded version of the template for product types. Amazon frequently updates templates, and old versions may be incompatible and could result in errors. Be sure to enable editing on the spreadsheet before making any revisions. If you don't enable this feature, you won't be able to save your changes. When you open your spreadsheet, you'll see multiple tabs. You'll add product information to the template tab. The instructions, images, example, data definitions, browse data, and valid values tabs provide information and guidance. Start by reviewing the instructions tab, which explains in detail how to use the template. It's worth reading this all the way through, especially the first time you create an inventory file. The Images tab outlines Amazon's image requirements. If you're including images for a new product, or if you're recommending updated images for an existing product, review this tab for important guidance. The Example tab provides several sample product rows for your reference. Take a look if you'd like to see in detail how your inventory file should look when it's completed. The Data Definitions tab defines each attribute within your inventory file. If you're unsure how to complete an attribute column or whether it's required, refer to this tab for definitions and use, accepted values, an example of each attribute, as well as the required or optional indicator. The Browse Data tab shows how your products will be found by customers browsing the Amazon store. Finally, the Valid Values tab provides a list of acceptable terms for certain product attribute columns. If you're unsure about an entry for a specific attribute, consult this table and select a value that appears in a corresponding row and column. Back on the Template tab, each row represents a single product. Use one row to match your offer to an existing listing or to create a product detail page and offer for a new product. Each column represents a single product attribute. There are hidden columns in the spreadsheet that can be unhidden by either clicking the two button in the top left corner to unhide all columns, or by clicking the plus button to unhide all columns individually. Start entering a product's information using the drop-down in column A for product type. Once you've made your selection, all the other required entries for the row will be outlined in red. If your template includes more than one product type, show multiple all entries for other product categories will be grayed out to indicate that they shouldn't be completed. You'll type many entries manually, but some will have a drop-down like column A. Make sure you don't edit any information in the first three rows highlighted in various colors. Doing so will cause errors during upload. Fill in each required entry in red, which will include the seller SKU, your stock keeping unit or personal seller identifier, and the external product ID, which will be the ASIN or a GTIN, like a UPC, ISBN, EAN, or JAN. The Record Action column is an important field in the spreadsheet because it will dictate whether you're making a change to every attribute or just some attributes. In some templates, the column is titled Record Action, and in other templates, the column is titled Update Delete. This column is used to make changes to all ASINs. The Partial Update column is used to update only specific attributes that have been entered. Your price is also a required field, even if it's zero for a business-only offer or an item that is out of stock. Next, fill in any unoutlined entries for optional attributes that you want to complete. After the required columns in red, you'll find variation column, an image column, and a choice to choose either parent or child under variation. For example, let's say you want to sell a women's shirt that comes in two different sizes, small and large. Maybe it also comes in two colors, yellow and blue. You'll want to start adding information with the parent item. The parent is a non-buyable, non-physical product and is only used to drive product searches and relate buyable child products. This means you only need to complete required columns for the parent items that fulfill these functions. In this example, outer material type is also required due to the product category. These will always include the seller SKU, brand, product ID, product type, title, item type, main image URL. For the child products, you'll need to complete all required attribute columns, as you would for any other buyable product. Some of these columns will be identical across a set of child products. The entry for brand must be the same for each child SKU to prevent submission errors. Other attribute columns require unique entries for each product variation because they are different for each child item. For example, different sizes or colors. These always include the seller SKU, title, which should include variation information like size and color, and product ID. Your varying attributes, your price, and main image URL could be the same or different according to the properties of each child product. After entering the required information for your parent and child products, you'll need to enter four additional attributes in your spreadsheet to establish the parent-child relationship. This information links your listings in the Amazon store. Get started by scrolling over to the variation column. In this column, choose parent for your parent item and child for each child item using the dropdown. Copy the parent SKU from column B into the variation section in the column parent SKU. Leave this column blank for the parent item. You'll also find columns related to the discovery of products in the Amazon store in green. Light green product enrichment columns for extra product information, yellow dimensions columns, and red fulfillment columns for shipping information. At the end of the spreadsheet, you'll find purple compliance columns, pink and burgundy offer columns for pricing and other listing information, and jade B2B columns for sellers listing product for Amazon Business customers. You'll want to leave column quantity US as zero until you're ready to launch. This way your product won't go live before you're ready to list. You'll also find variation options in teal. Some sellers fill out every attribute column. Some fill out only required columns. In general, the more data you provide, the more information and options customers have while making purchasing decisions. Remember that once you've completed a row for a product, you can keep a saved copy of your file to make quick and easy edits to your product and listing information later. However, it's not recommended to use templates that are more than 90 days old. Instead, download the latest templates to avoid submission errors. When you finish adding products to your inventory file template, make sure you save your changes and keep a copy for your records. Then you're ready for the third and final step, uploading your file to Seller Central. Under the Spreadsheet tab, select Upload File. Drag and drop your file or click Browse Files to search for and select your file. Once your file is validated, the Submit Products button will activate. If your file type isn't recognized, a dropdown will appear instead, and you'll be able to select your file type. Before uploading, you can select Receive Email Notifications about this feed if you'd like to be notified when your file is done processing. When you're ready, click the Submit Products button. If you're only uploading information for a few products, it will take a few minutes to process. Larger uploads can take several hours. Your inventory will be available for purchase in the Amazon store once the upload is complete. You can check the status of an upload by clicking Check Upload Status under the Spreadsheet tab, which lists the date, time, batch ID, status, and a link to the processing report for your most recent completed uploads. Check your processing report to address any errors. You'll use this process to match offers to existing listings, and you'll use it to create product detail pages and listings for new products. You can use a single inventory file to both match and create listings. If your file includes a product ID or GTIN for an item, and a matching ID exists in the Amazon store, we'll match your offer to the existing product detail page. We'll also attempt to match a product by manufacturer or other information if you don't include a product ID. If we can't match a product to an existing product in the Amazon store, we'll create a new product detail page. After adding product listings to your inventory, you can use the same process to make edits to listings or to suggest changes to product detail pages in bulk. Start by going back to your saved inventory file, and for faster processing, remove any products you don't want to adjust. Then save the new copy. If you just want to edit an offer, update your price, quantity, business price, or any other offer-related information in your inventory file, you can leave all other entries the same. Note that if you delete an offer-related entry, it will register as a zero on Seller Central. For example, deleting a price for a product will set the price at $0. If you're a qualified seller and want to suggest changes to your product detail page, make the suggested updates in the relevant attribute column. After making edits to your inventory file, you can upload it normally. You'll see the offer updates within 15 minutes of your upload. We'll also review suggested product changes and make any updates within 24 hours. If for any reason you want to replace your entire inventory in the Amazon store, there is also an option under the Spreadsheet tab to purge and replace your inventory. You'll click the link to select this option, then upload your inventory file normally. Keep in mind that this will delete all your current listings in the Amazon store, including any products not in the file you're currently uploading. It will replace your entire inventory with the products in your new file only. Matching and creating product listings in bulk might seem daunting at first, but the extra effort can save you time, energy, and effort in the long run. Thank you, and happy selling in the Amazon store!